Remember,
don't try this at home.
Ever.
We're professionals.
No sleep till...
Else who could do it? What was that?
I can do it.
Oh, zipline.
Good.
In the air like it's good to be alive. And I'm a famous rapper even when the paths are all crooked. I can show you how to do-si-do. I can show you how to scratch a record. I can take apart the remote control, and I can almost put it back together. I can tie a knot in a cherry stem. I can tell you about Leif Erikson. I know all the words to De Colores, and I'm proud to be an American. Me and my friends are platypus. Me and my friend made a comic book, and guess how long it took. I can do anything that I want, cause look, I can keep rhythm with no metronome. No metronome. No metronome. And I can see your face on the telephone. On the telephone. On the telephone.
Yeah, put some more kindling on that.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Gear ratios directly affect the amount of torque it takes to go a certain velocity on bicycle.
Whoa.
That
what?
Is fire, dude.
Let me see that. Why, are you kidding me? Is this the New York Times or something?
No, dude, this is wow, this is that... the Bicycle Science newspaper.
Oh, I what forgot we got this.
So the first thing that we did is that we needed to find the initial going off the ramp. We know that the distance from the edge of the ramp to where he landed was 4.877 meters, and we know that the height of the ramp was 0.762 meters, and the mat he landed on was 0.457 meters. So that's going to make our delta y negative 0.305 meters because you subtract these two numbers. And then we're doing a projectile problem, might I add. And we found, so things we're looking for, the initial on the y, the final on the y, we don't care about. The acceleration is negative 9.8 meters per second squared because of gravity. And then the time, we timed how long it took him from the edge of the ramp to when he landed using high quality video software timing mechanisms, and we found that to be 0.70 seconds. So we did a whole bunch of math, and we came to discover that VY, the initial in the Y is 3.87 meters per second. And we also needed to find V initial in the X. So V final in X, we don't care about that. The initial in X is what we're trying to find. The acceleration is zero because in the X direction there was no acceleration during a projectile problem. The delta X is 4.877 meters, as I declared before. The time, again, is 0.70 seconds. So we discovered, among many math problems, that V initial in X is 6.97 meters per second. And our angle of the ramp, which is the angle at which the final angle of the ramp at which Trey leaves, is 29 degrees. And we this all checks out with this great triangle right here, to find our V initial to be 7.97 meters per second is how fast Trey was going as he left the ramp. The equation that we used for our projectile problem was this beautiful equation right here, and then we rearranged it to solve for V initial and the Y. Dude, you are so garbage, I'm gonna destroy you now. Now the pros are here.
Okay, so we found the velocity, and by assuming the bicycle tire does not slip on the ground, we can relate the tangential velocity, the tire, or relating the tire to the speed from the ground, and you can do VT equals omega R, which is your tangential speed equals your angular speed times your radius. We found the radius of the bicycle tire to be 0.279 meters, and by plugging it into the equation, 7.97 meters per second equals omega times 0.279, we get 27.9 radians per second for our angular speed. And we can assume that the bicycle is one system by that it spins together, because all your force propelling you forward is on your back tire, and that's where all your force comes from.
Alrighty, so since we're solving for torque, we need alpha, or angular acceleration, and our moment of inertia. So to get our angular acceleration, we plug in omega over our time. We got our time from the video, from the time where I started pedaling to the time I stopped pedaling. We get 27.9 over 4.1, and our angular acceleration comes out to be 6.8 radians per second squared. Since we treat the bicycle as one system on the back tire, we're going to use this equation, I equals mr squared. And we took the mass of me and the bike, which comes out to be 95.71 kilograms. We plug it in, and our moment of inertia is 7.45 kilograms meters squared. And then since we have our moment of inertia and our angular acceleration, we plug it into the torque equation, and we get our torque to be 50.66 newton meters.
Get this man a chair!
So, we solved for the torque being 50.66 newton meters, and now that was for the back gear. So we're going to try and relate that to the front gear by using the force times the lever arm. The lever arm being the length of the pedal, which we measured to be 0.18 meters. And then rearranging this equation, we can just solve for force, and we'll be done.
Hey, you're forgetting.
Whoa! Time. Hey, get out of here!
Man, I'm just trying to help, man. You forgot the gear ratio.
I'm sorry, I've just assumed because of how this has been going.
So in gears, when they're connected, they can either increase torque or speed. You have your input and your output, and they change direction. When they are not connected or powered by a chain, they stay in the same direction from your input to your output.
The gear ratio can be calculated by counting the number of spokes on this gear and the number of spokes on this gear. Your gear ratio is given by your input gear to over your output gear. You're pedaling on this gear, so this is your input gear, which gives you a gear ratio of 44 to 16, or 2.75.
For our bicycle, we had 44 teeth on the input gear, and we divide that by 16 teeth from the output gear, and we got 2.75. You take the 2.75 and you multiply it by the torque on the back gear, which will equal the torque on the front gear, which equals the force times the lever arm.
Thanks a lot, Cole. Okay, so now we have our lever arm as 0.18 meters. So we multiplied our torque by the gear ratio. We got 139.32 on the front gear. And then we used torque equals force times the lever arm. And we solve for force using those numbers that we found. And force equals 773.97 newtons. We did it, guys. We found the force that we needed.
I hate this glass. Oh. Yeah, I can. But what?
not just broke. What is this?
Back pedal of the wheel.
Whoa. No.
Hey, you need a cue.
Hey guys, look here. It says gear ratio change direction.
That's not what I said to say. It's not as funny as I thought it would be.